So one thing that often gets brought up when we talk about Trump is that no one in his inner circle, especially at his corporation, seems to be willing to really flip on him. And so if no one's going to snitch on Donald Trump, then are you really going to be able to take him down? Don't you need that inside voice to really get him on both civil and criminal things? But a legal expert earlier today made a fantastic argument and said that Donald Trump is such a bald-faced, blatant, incompetent liar that he's already snitched on himself and he's getting himself into bigger trouble civilly and criminally.
So it's less about testimony and more about the documents. And the documents are plain as day. The thing you showed earlier, Joy, really just puts the nail, it hits the nail right on the head. That is a 3,300% disparity between what they reported to a lender and what they reported to the tax authorities. These numbers really speak for themselves. Donald Trump didn't need anyone, didn't need anybody to snitch on him. He snitched on himself with how broad of a disparity that was. This could take an economic wrecking ball to the Trump organization. This could mean hundreds of millions of dollars in back taxes, penalties, other fees that he could have to pay to the state as well as to the lenders that he defrauded. So this could be ruinous for him financially.
And could he then face the criminal case if Cy Vance's case is connected?
Exactly. He's going to face it with a 1-2 punch. He's going to have the civil case and the criminal case going. We didn't realize until today how far along the civil case is. This is really far along. We wouldn't bring in somebody for this kind of testimony. Like we were just saying, 90% plus of this case is already built. So this is really far along. He's going to get it. Trump's going to get it from both directions on this one.
So you heard there, he is referencing what we talked about a few weeks ago, how Donald Trump was taking one of his buildings and simultaneously said it was worth $500 million to a bank and less than $20 million to the tax man, which is a 3,300% difference, which is so off the walls crazy that it is Trump snitching on himself. That expert says there, it is very, very clear. And as they note, right now the focus is civil, but the civil penalties could be massive. It could take, as noted there, a wrecking ball to the Trump organization. And as further noted, this is happening in the 1-2 punch with the civil and criminal case in New York. And what's really great to see there, because we've talked about it and a lot of people have asked me in the comments saying, well, how far along is this really? And I wasn't exactly sure because I'm not on the ground and I'm not a legal expert, but this guy is. And what he says is that with Letitia James bringing Donald Trump in for a subpoena, dragging him in to court to give a deposition, and also with her not running for governor, she's decided not to run for governor, that shows that this case is far closer to being done and dusted, where they can bring charges against Trump, than we ever previously thought. And so I think this is so, so delicious. Not just the fact that things are moving faster than we thought, not just the 1-2 punch, but really at the core, the idea that all of this focus on, can you get Weisselberg to flip? Can you get Calamari to flip? Can you get the Trump kids to flip on daddy? I'm not saying that doesn't matter, but there's a really great point that with Trump being so obviously criminal and so obviously dishonest, the biggest snitcher on Trump is Trump himself. And I think it's purely fitting that he is the one that will send himself to prison. It is the most delicious outcome.